I have a couple of novels I'm working on, but I don't know which one to write on now. If you had to choose, would it be the easy to write story, or the harder but more fulfilling story, or the quiet, quirky story? When I'm choosing what project to work on next, it is what is the most ready to be worked on. What is the most complete? What is the most fleshed out? Which one do I have the most for? And a lot of the times I have to battle myself because I want to write this thing that I'm the most passionate about, which is, you know, that's good, but your passion can only carry you so far. So once you get so far into it and then all of a sudden you're at a brick wall and you don't know what else to, that's why whatever is the most fleshed out, ready to go, complete, that's what I'm working on. What is the best way to learn how to pace a novel versus how to pace a short story? Reading is the number one, pretty much the only thing, is just read and read and read and read and read and read and then read some more and then read a little bit more. And then when you're done reading, you should go pick up a book and read. That's the only way to figure out pacing. That and to write, but reading is the big thing when it comes to pacing. I cannot get past my first rewrite. I just think my story is shit, so I scrap it. At what point in your writing career were you finally able to get past your edit? I mean, for me, it was early on just because I was motivated. I was like, yeah, I'm going to get this thing done. But I have had projects since then where I've completed the first draft and I go back and I'm like, oh, this thing is not good. But yeah, stuff gets scrapped. That happens. I've done it. Stephen King has done it. Everybody has done it. They're called trunk novels or just throwaway. They're like, you wrote the novel, but it's not any good. And you know that. You recognize it, so you throw it away. The big thing, though, is if you did put all this work into writing a first draft of a novel. That's probably 85-90% of the work of writing a book. So don't just willy-nilly throw that work away. What I would recommend is if like it looks bad, you're not enjoying it, put it aside, go work on something else, maybe 6 months, maybe a year later, pick it back up, look at it with a fresh perspective. I know with the Third Bridge World, which I'm wrapping up right now on the final things, when I finished the first draft, I was like, that, it really didn't turn out the way I wanted it to. You know, and I set it aside for like a year now. And when I came back to it, I was like, oh, okay, well, it's better than I thought. You know, looking at it from an outside perspective, because when you've been working on something, you're sick of it, you're like, eh. So, yeah, if you feel like it's crap, set it aside, come back to it later. If it's still crap when you come back to it 6 months or a year later, eh, maybe it's crap. So, you know, don't delete it, but, you know, leave it buried in your hard drive or the manuscript buried somewhere. Maybe 10 years later, come back to it. And if it's still shit then, eh, it was a shit book. How do you deal with underwriting? I feel my stories always move too fast, even with subplots. 100% common for young writers. I think every young writer is going to deal with underwriting. The big thing is it's just experience. The more you write, the more you get used to it. And I've said this before, but it is the truth of the, you have to figure out what it feels like for the pacing of writing versus the pacing of reading. Because when you're reading, you're reading 100 times faster than you write. So when you're writing a scene, you feel like you've been working on the scene for ages and it's a massive, huge scene. But then, you know, you hand it to a reader, they go through it in 2 minutes, tops. So you have to figure out how does this writing pacing translate over to reading pacing. And the only way to do that is just experience. Back in your How to Write a Novel series, you said that you should get a laser printer. Do you still stand by that? And do you recommend any specific brands? For the most part, I do stand by it. It's just like the final rewrite. It's nice to be able to print it out, have a hard copy in it. It looks different. It reads different. It's just a different experience from reading it on your computer again. If you don't have the money to get a laser printer, like financial or just whatever reason, it's not like a requisite. You'll still be able to write a book without one, but I do think that final rewrite, being able to have that hard copy that you take a red pen to, it's really, really helpful. Brands, whatever you can find cheap. Brother has cheap laser printers. Laser printers have really, really come down in price in the last 5 or 6 years. I remember when I got mine, I was really lucky to get one for like $150. And now I think you can get one for like $80. B&H Photo, just like they're not sponsoring this, but that's a great place to get electronics from, especially if you don't live in New York or New Jersey, because you don't have to pay sales tax, which is awesome. Saves you a bunch of money when you're buying more expensive stuff. I have issues with changing my writing tone. Example, when everything is funny and cheerful, it turns to a horror story with two-headed demons in it. I can't seem to create the shock effect on the reader. Do you have any tips for me? Okay, some people, like, they want tonal consistency through the book. If this is a horror story, it needs to be horrific all the way through. It needs to be that, you know, same dreadful, terrible tone. But for me, I mean, mix it up. You have a lighthearted scene, then you have a serious scene. You know, it's like, change the tone. It's fine. I'm fine with that. Other people won't be, but me personally, I think it's great. I think because one thing for too long, I get bored of it. It doesn't matter what it is, if it's too long, if it's the same thing for too much time, I get bored with it. When you're talking about, you know, like everybody's having a good time, then they walk into a room and there's a murder there. Well, that's how you do it. They walk into a room and there's a murder there. You know, everything stops cold, sounds. You just write it. And what you're doing for the scene, showing the scene, it can really, it's gonna naturally convey itself to the reader in tone. Now, if, you know, they're just going along and something action-y happens, well, you can change the flow of the sentences. So you have long, flowy sentences, compound, complex, you know, multiple commas and clauses and all that stuff. Then you start chopping it down and you got shorter, more abrupt sentences, you know, 2-3 word sentences, or, you know, just really, really choppiness. So you just work with the flow of the prose itself. Action is going to be choppy normally, not necessarily like staccato, choppy, but it's not going to be long and flowing and beautiful and graceful. So yeah, work with the prose. But those are our 6 questions for today. So if you have writing related questions, you need to leave them below or tweet them at me using the hashtag of writing tips. I pick 3 from each. So until next time, keep writing.